Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Eva and I'm doing lifestyle and motherhood videos. Today I am coming with 18 months baby update. She's not really a baby anymore. She is definitely a toddler. She turned 18 months yesterday. I am sorry if this video will be very chaotic and all of that because, you know, she may want to touch everything and all of this and talk a lot. So I am apologizing for this, but let's not make it unnecessarily long and let's talk. So let's start with the stats. Maya weighs 28 pounds. So she is definitely a big girl and she is wearing 2T clothes. Some of the 18 months old still fits her, but she's definitely in 2T the most comfortable. So she is definitely a big girl. She has 4, 8, 9, 10, 11 teeth. And the 12 is poking up right now and she's definitely struggle with this and it's in pain and I am just feeling so sorry for her, but you know, this is how it is. So let's go jump right into maybe sleeping first. So Maya drop her naps. Yes, she doesn't sleep anymore and this is just so sad. Sometimes she will if she is very very tired or when she wakes up way too early, but for the most of the time she doesn't nap anymore. And she was at daycare for one day and their biggest complaint was their biggest question was how to put her to sleep for a nap because she did not sleep even for a second. And I do not know answer for this question because this is something what I am struggling myself. Also, she is going to sleep at 7 p.m. and all I have to do is to just put her to the crib, give her her blanket. She sleeps with a receiving blanket. This is her favorite thing in the world. So she needs that and once she get it, she is completely fine and falls asleep on her own. She doesn't cry or anything. Sorry, I just have to keep moving and running away from her. So yeah, sleeping it's okay. Like I wish she would nap. She will still wake up at night once. I will talk about breastfeeding a little bit later. But she still wakes up once and this is just like you should be sleeping by now, you know, like you are 18 months, why are you still waking up? But that's how it is. Just recently for last few days she is waking up at 5 a.m. and you know she doesn't want to go back to sleep, but she is still tired. I know she is still tired because she is crying. And I'm spending so much time in her bedroom, like trying to put her back to sleep, and it's just like almost impossible. Like even this morning, I spent in her room like almost an hour from like 4 something to 5. But this is only recently. Prior to that, she was really amazing. She was sleeping until like 7 or 8 a.m. So yeah, that's definitely that. When it's coming to feeding, like I swear, eating is her superpower because she eats everything I give her. There is no problem at all when it's coming to eating. To eat, she enjoys eating everything. And also yesterday she ate like a little bowl of salad, guys. Like what other 18 months old or like a child likes to eat salads? I like to believe that my child is unique in this area. Maya, don't climb up on it. You're gonna fall down. Look what she's doing. She doesn't really have a favorite food. I would say she likes everything. Like really, really everything except spicy. She still doesn't like spicy, but what you can do. So, okay, breastfeeding. I narrow down to one time, and that's at around 2 a.m. I know that I have to resolve the problem of her waking up at 4 a.m. before I move to anything else, because it is definitely a problem and I just like hate it so much. I just hate it so much. Anyway, so that's what I have to do. And if you have any tips for, you know, stop breastfeeding even that one time, I would really appreciate it if you leave it down in the comment. How I win her off from the other breastfeeding sessions is that I just cut one by one. So let's say I fed her before nap time and then like four times at night, like she was waking up every 2 to 3 hours to be fed, and that was absolutely crazy. So I start with the naps. As she was dropping her naps, I drop her feeding. So that was pretty easy. Then she was napping one time during the day, and she was crying a little bit at first, of course. She wasn't happy at all that this is not happening, but overall it went quite smooth, I would say. The worst it was at night and before going to bed. So I started with weaning her off before she goes to bed. I felt like this is the next right step to do, and also the easiest one. That was definitely tough at first because she did not want to fall asleep, and she was crying and crying, but eventually she learned. And also what changed, so prior to that, when I was like breastfeeding her, I had to like breastfeed her, she would fall asleep and I put her down, and when I tried to wean her off, I would still take her on and rock her and all of that. But then something just happened and she didn't like it anymore. I just had to put her down. I would like change her diaper, put her pajama on, put her to the crib, turn off the light, say goodnight, all of that, and leave. And she would just fall asleep on her own. So that was definitely cool. The next feeding I dropped, it was, then she would wake up, I would feed her, and I would drop the one after that. And you know, this was all over like a period of time. It wasn't like instantly right away. It was like, oh, come on, Maya. I dropped like one feeding every week, I would say. Whatever felt comfortable and whatever she felt comfortable. It definitely took like months to wean her off. I would say I started 14 months old, and just move very, very slowly. Sorry, I just have to look what she's doing because she has very weird ideas. So yeah, for the longest time I had only two feedings at night, and just recently I narrowed down to one. And yeah, it's definitely going to be hard as everything else, because you know, it's hard to put them back to sleep. Like, she wakes up and she says milk. She can talk, which I will talk about in a second. But I am so happy that this is almost over. Like, almost over. I am so close to be done breastfeeding my toddler. I would never think in a million years that it would take me so long. I was always saying, like, 1 year max. But you know what? Your baby is always a baby for you. And it's tough. It's really, really tough. So yeah, I think she's coming back. So yeah, that is the breastfeeding. If you have any questions, if I missed to say anything, then just let me know down below. I will also add that I did not switch to any whole milk or anything like that. I didn't want her to have one addiction to other addiction. You know, if I give her like a sippy cup full of cow's milk, she will get used to it. Thank you, Maya, for doing this. It would definitely wasn't something what I wanted to happen, right? That she developed something else, I will have to win her off. Ooh. Oh, that was so cool. Anyway, that's our breastfeeding. Now let's talk about development. So Maya is definitely doing, thanks Maya, she's definitely doing great. She talks like crazy. She can put two words together, and that's a lot. So I recently made a video about my older daughter, who is 3 years old right now, that she has a speech delay. And at 18 months, she wasn't talking at all. Like, she was saying mama, papa, and then just like some nonsense, where this little one can put two very simple words together, and that's just warms my heart so much. She repeats a lot, like a lot. Whatever I will say, she will repeat. Can you say hi? Hi? Can you say dog?
No.
Can you say cat?
No cat.
No cat? Can you say daddy? What is your name?
Daddy.
Your name is not daddy. What is your name?
Cat.
She doesn't say her name, she says baby, because her older sister taught her that her name is baby. And I can't get rid of it. Right, Maya? What
Daddy.
What other words do you know? What other words do you know? Ah. Oh, do you know berry? What's your favorite berry?
Berry.
Okay. Do you like strawberry?
Yeah,
okay. Do you like apples?
Yeah.
Do you like water? Do you like water?
Yeah.
Okay, and what you don't like? Do you like spicy?
Spicy,
yeah. Do you like spicy food?
No.
Okay. We're gonna open the door for the dog. Are we going to open the door for the dog?
Yeah.
She's also saying open door for everything. Even when the things she wants to open, it's not a door. She doesn't really have any favorite toy. She will play everything what her sister is playing with. She has unlimited screen time because it's not that I am against TV or anything at all, because they do have screen time, but very limited. My older daughter watch a little bit more than the younger one. Actually, Maya doesn't have really much of an interest except Paw Patrol. She does like that one, Friends. Mostly the older one is more, it wants to interact more. But the little one also like will go and give her like a hug or a kiss. They fight a lot, like, don't take me wrong, they definitely fight like crazy, and sometimes it's not cool. Here she is. But I can't complain, because I have perfect to grow. Oh, now my dog wants to grow also. This is the most unorganized baby update in the world. But I don't have much time to film, because my older daughter is going to come back from a walk soon, and I wish to be done soon. Go, dog. So I think I covered pretty much everything. If there is anything you would like to know, just ask in the comments. I would be happy to answer all your questions about this little precious girl. Where is she running now? I love those vlogs, guys. Like, I don't know about you, if you make YouTube videos or not, but if you do and you have like a my dog is back. If you do like a kids content, I love to look at those vlogs back. Those are such a precious memories, right, Maya? So who else? Yeah, the speech is, I guess, like the biggest thing I'm focusing on, because obviously I want her to talk as much as possible. So life is so much easier, right? She's still in diapers. I didn't say that before. She's still in diapers, size 5, could be 6, but she's in 5, because, you know, bigger volume of diapers in one package. So yeah, she doesn't show any signs of being ready. And I wish she was potty trained. Her older sister, which I will make her you know, toddler child update next. So yeah, my little Maya is 18 months old. I am pretty sure that her 2-year-old update is gonna be huge because she's definitely changing every single day. So this is it for today. It is definitely the most all over the place update I have ever done, but thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give me a big thumbs up, subscribe if you are new, give me a like, of course. Maybe share with someone who has a toddler and would like to, you know, not compare, because we don't compare our children, because each one is unique. But, you know, someone who may want to see how other children are doing at that specific age. This is my very old dog. She's so old, guys. That is so sad. Anyway, thank you again for watching, and I hope I will see you with my next vlog. Bye!